eating a diet that's high in fibers, so such as whole grain bread or oatmeal, for example, is rich in fibers, and fruits and vegetables are rich in fiber. Avoiding those red meats that are high in saturated fat, but instead focusing on white meat, especially fish and other healthy oils. These are most common foods that can actually help lower cholesterol. My name is Dr. Mahmoud Al Rifai. I'm a cardiologist at Houston Methodist. If you have high cholesterol, we always need to counsel our patients on adhering to a good diet that is low in saturated fats. So that includes fried foods, processed foods, red meats, and then high sugar, so candy and dessert, that can also contribute to elevated cholesterol. Limiting alcohol intake can also help improve cholesterol levels. So these are some of the foods that we can try to counsel patients on avoiding. High keto diets, so those are the diets that are low in carbohydrates but high in saturated fats, actually can cause extremely high cholesterol numbers. So if you're someone who already has high cholesterol or has high risk factors for cardiovascular disease, I would avoid a keto diet. Or if you want to do a keto diet, you do it under very controlled settings. So you get a baseline lipid profile and then you follow them up over time, because that cholesterol numbers can really increase with a keto diet. So that's one kind of diet I would avoid. When I counsel my patients on what is the best diet for them, it's commonly the Mediterranean diet or the DASH diet, because they have the most data on improvements in cholesterol. I wouldn't avoid eggs, but I will say that eggs in moderation are okay. A few times a week, consuming eggs is fine. If you were to do more than two eggs, I'd probably take out a couple of the egg yolks and use more egg white, because that's where the most of the bad cholesterol is, in the egg yolk. The egg white is richer in protein, so that's why people will try to eat more of the egg whites and avoid the egg yolks.